is a credential. The children of Israel, the Bible said they cried unto God, and the throne and the God remembered his covenant. They cried, make God to remember his covenant. What is covenant? Covenant is within the weak and the strong. Covenant. I'm not talking of many covenants. Hello? Don't have any covenant with anybody, please. Maybe, you know, say a man and woman, when they are dating themselves, a girlfriend and boyfriend, I know you are traveling to South Africa. I know you are traveling to America. Let us do a covenant that you must come back and marry you. And then they share blood. I get me. That covenant is if it's a courting covenant. You are practicing or practicing. It's a courting regular. That means that you want to supervise one. Hear this. If anyone break that covenant, come on with that. This one breaking it with that, that one breaking it with that. What kind of covenant? But the covenant with God is within the weak and the strong. A woman came to meet me and heard it there on Saturday. And on Friday, another 7 o'clock, the woman of 51 years old in ministry, and came to meet me, a small boy. And he said to me, he said, Prophet, he said, I'm troubled, I don't know what is happening. I said, woman, let us pray. As I was praying, I saw that they are breaking some covenant. And I said, woman, I said, mommy, you break some covenant, and that is why you are going through some sickness or pain in your body. And he said, yes, yes, sir. Sir, I have one covenant with God. Over 25 years, I have not break the covenant. Over 25 years. But suddenly, I don't know what happened to me. I broke the covenant, and I don't know. Is it the one that makes my back? Everywhere is paining me. I can't sleep for the past 3 months. I cannot sleep. And that is why I come up there. I was going from one doctor to one doctor, from one doctor to dear, not native doctor, because she's a great born again. She's a reverend. All of us, we know her. She said she was going for one doctor. And I said, now, she has got that money to go for operation or surgery or anything in London. Then he just needs more money to gather. Then he wants to travel this week. That then to go and do maybe some tests. And after he takes the suspension, he will go to the doctor. But they told her that her skin with her bone met together, and that's the result of what is happening to her. And when he said that to me, I said, woman, I said, mommy, can I tell you something? I said, you break a covenant, and then you are being tormented, and then you are looking for where we may have. Hear this. I said, ma'am, I said, listen, God, it is not devil that is attacking you. It is not anybody that is afflicting you. It is because the covenant you break, God wants you to apologize. The Bible said, and Saul rebelled against God, disobeyed God. Amen? And the Bible said, the evil spirit from God, the evil, not from the devil, the evil spirit from God came to trouble Saul. Why God knows you evil spirit from the devil? Any child of God, are you getting me? They have done something wrong. God cannot hand you over to the devil. Hello? You know your credential. Your credential is that you give your life to Christ. Hello? Say, God, I'm born again. It's a credential. Many people ask that they are not born again. Your credential is that I'm here in the church. It's your credential. If you don't have enough, but only that one is enough to ask God. And then the woman said, I said, the pain you are going through, the pain is from God, not attack from the pit of hell. And that is why you are going to pain. And I said, woman, hear this as the prophet of God. I said, I'm telling you this, let us go into the throne of grace. And I walked half down here. I will stand in the altar. And we began to declare. I began to pray. I said, happily that, tell God you are sorry. He said, God, I'm sorry. And I'm sorry. I said, stop. You don't need to repeat it over and over. Say, God, I'm sorry. It's not a deaf God. It's not a deaf and dumb. Once you hear, twice we believe that it's power belongs all to God. I said, you are sorry. Say, sorry. I said, okay, just take God, you are sorry. Say, okay, no problem. You can go, man. He said, eh? I said, go. Hey, he said, Papa, that is all. I said, that is all. I said, that pain, you will sleep like baby, and you will feel no pain again. And he said, Prophet, he looked at me. He said, the money I'm going for operation in UK, I'll pack the pounds. He said, I'm sending it to the account of the church that God has healed me, but she's still feeling the pain. You know what happened? Immediately he said that he fell down under another rule of law. I picked her up and I said, Mark, you are free. And then he called me the next day. I was coming to my service on night meeting. I mean, my phone had been ringing around that 6 o'clock. I was saying, attention to people. I look at it. He texts me. He said, for the past 3 months, I sleep like people. You know what happened? Her credential. Sit down. Have you seen it? Credential, it matters. Look at me, look at me. What you give to God matter a lot in your life. Not only in your life, in your generation. Have you ever wake up one day and you call somebody and make that person to smile? I thank God I have a new car. I thank God I really have. I thank God I have a children. I thank God I've been. Have you ever wake up one day and call someone and said, I want to do this for you? Let me tell you some testimony about election. I woke up one day in the morning and I went to the orphanage home. I see the children there, and I just with them, I'm very happy. Then, and I asked them what their problem. And they told me that the problem is that nearby our school is very far from this side. Sometimes we don't go. Sometimes we see food that is we eat 3 times a day. We give God the praise. Mommy is trying. He said, the only way that we just need something just to a bus, a car that we carry us, or something we just do there. Give the movie one transportation money and then they come back at the school. And I came to their place with the school bus, with my bus. I'm driving the bus there. They call it to Nuzanfanet. Nuzanfanet. When I came into it, I look at it, the tire is not good enough, but the engine is sound. And when I head out, I drove the car with them. And I gave them some money according to my level there to change on the tire. And I walk away with the Okada back to the place I'm living. I'm not married then. I'm still a single. And then the woman, which was the mother of the orphan, she cannot thank me enough. I said, don't thank me, thank God. Now I wake up in the morning, I said, let me meet the need of somebody. Now I need help. Are you getting me? But I don't want to go and beg anybody for help. But I can provoke the heaven. He said, when my help coming, he called from the Lord that make heaven and earth. That make us heaven and earth. Listen, sometimes you can wake up recently, I woke up in the morning and I called him. And I said to her, and I began to ask her some questions. And after asking her some questions, he told me a lot of things and a lot of things like that. And she was going to begin to do blah, 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 blah. After I said, there's no problem. And I wrote a check of half, it's not up to 500,000. I wrote the check. That is the only money in my own personal account. It's not up to 500,000. I said, take the check, go and cash the money, pay it to your account. I want to pay it to your account. And then you can get yourself. She began to cry, she cried. I said, mind you, don't be the husband to come and prostrate here. Just text me. Say thank you. I know they would like to come and say thank you. Just text me. But give glory to God. You know why I did that? Because there's some things I don't want to do for me. Let me make somebody happy. And God can make me happy. Now, those are the credentials that God is looking in the time of trouble, in the time of need. In the time of trouble. I have seen to a point of death that everybody have given up. They have given up. The hope is lost. Because I was down. But hear me. One day, the last day, when I look at it, that the prophet told me, he said, Prophet of Allah, what I saw in the realm of the spirit is possible. And the man shall expect it when he speaks, heaven responds. He said, just pray and hand over everything to God and have all the ministry to everybody, with your brother, and then God is calling you. You are going home in 3 days' time. And I said, oh, thank you. But I bless your name. And I said, please go forth and tell God. And I said with him that, that I disagree. At the point of death, he said, I disagree. He said, who am I to go and thank God? He said, the Supreme God in the heaven judge you and everything. God judge you. You are taking God to God of appeal. Who will judge it? Who will go to judge God of appeal? Is it not God? And I said, go back and thank God. I said to him that I'm not ready. And then he said, no. He said, who am I? I'm just an ordinary messenger. To go and tell the just and what? I cannot promote you to send them. I said, I'll send you back. He said, he can't go back. He said, thank you. Have a good day. I said, okay, you can go. And I turned and I shipped myself back. And I put myself on the floor. And I asked them, I said, naked me. They naked me. I said, put me on the altar. And I was telling God. I said, my God, remember my sacrifice. My God, remember my sacrifice. God said, you must die. I said, no. Ibane, Jesu, Ibane, Baba, Ibane, Jesu, Ibane, Baba, Ajubane, Omolong, Ibane, Baba, Ajubane. Now, when I was singing that, God meeting his mind. The voice I was hearing, it is your time. And I said, oh, I just want to say, Baba, oh, hey, ni Baba, don't you, Baba, Lord, hey, ni Baba, don't you, Baba. I dread many other people to write on time. So I give my life, I pray for people. Anything you want me to do, I do it, and I told you. And they said they requested for a born again man that we die for. God, I'm ready to go there and sacrifice my life and kill me, and then they can release those people for them to serve you. I've sent that to God. And when I began to worship him, you know what I hear from the heaven? And I hear God say, I have changed my mind.
Devil was killing the devil.
children one by one. After he get to the ninth one, he get to myself and say, now, what is happening? He give up. Do you know why? Because he doesn't have credential. You are not a giver. You can't give your first fruits, salary. The day they are sacking people in the office, your name will be wooden. Since I came in January, after I was talking about first fruit. Bring your first fruit to God. Praise God. let me pick up you. I said first fruit. I know the sister used to collect. Her salary is about 800,000. Collect 800,000. First fruit. In your first fruit. Hey, in the name of Jesus. Pay your first fruit. If you didn't hear with my, let me go. Say, Daddy, I'm dead. He brought the first fruit. He asked me, I said, I can't give you a salary. I said, but you can pay my fees. He wrote the check and he gave me the money. I think for saying this, there's a food this January in my pocket. Father, all my sweat here this January, I'll get something before the end of the year, of the month. Thank you. I start to wait from the end of my. Shortly, they need to send some people away in the home. That is said, not. Our name was there. Get back to me. I said, Prophet, God has answered the prayer. I said, but I told you that when you pray your first one, do something. Say, ha. I said, God has served me so different. Nobody ever, you know, we pass or we post. And he said, please let us respond. I said, I don't know what the government. What's the meaning? He said, they sack. They sack you. Give me the letter. And I take the letter. I come to the doctor. I say, God, 800,000. The time is 40. If everybody to give back, this person will give time of what? 40,000. And I've told her to be giving double tax. His time is 80,000. In prophetic seed is 80,000. If only this lady, are you getting it? Lost her whole job. The church is closed already. I said, God, what can we do? I said, God, remember our sacrifice. And I tore the letter. I said, tore the letter. And she went back. She said, yes, I called her. You know, I called her after the week. I said, where? She said, well, Prophet, we are the after 40 in the store. I said, no, go back to the prophet. I've been calling your number, it's not going. He said, Prophet, I have your number. I said, they have been calling your number, it's not going. He said, Prophet, there's an email. They will send an email. I just received one email today that I just went on that day. All the car, I drive him to come and submit the key. And I said, okay. How do you want to do it? I said, they are calling your phone. It's not, your email is not going. Go back to the company. We went back to the company and tell the president that you want to come and drop the key. And we went there. And they said, you drop your key? He said, yes. They said, who drop it? Who are you among us? My name is number one in the list. The list? Where's the list? We have been looking for you. Come back to your work. You are no more than staff again. You are now ATM of the company. It is what God used to fight for you in the part of your need. Yes. Credential. Generally, I talk about credential. If you remember me, I talk about credential. That it is your credential that God will use to pay you at the end of the year. If you are not a tither, you don't have credential. If you are not a giver, you don't have credential. The seed I have sown this year, the seed I have sown this year, if they bring out the shop together and I've been number two or number three. You know, some people are like, I don't know. I know they have done that. The seed I have sown this year. The seed I sow this year. In fact, it's enough for me to reap what I want to reap. Listen, it's a result of the seed you sow. It's a result of what you reap. Credential starts from what you have been given to God. What the enemy do to prevent the insults is their own credential. They went to the devil. Devil, I give you my seven children to be, to bring their blood. And who is this person? He that is shouting. Credential matter. Look at the scripture in the book of 1 Samuel. The Bible said, and David went forth to the war, and he saw his brother, and went back to give them the food. And when he saw, he said, who was it? Saul. He said, who is this Philistine that is shouting? And the son said to him, he said, don't come near here. He said, Goliath is a man of war. He has been fighting over 40 years. He has not lost one battle. He said, this time around. He said, don't yet. He said, sir, I have credential. He said, what's your credential? He said, the other day, I mean, my father keeps sheep. He said, the other day, a lion came. I kill lion. He said, well, everybody kill lion. He said, hey. He said, not my lion. He said, then. He said, you know what shocked me? He said, when bear appear, I kick bear. I grab him on his bear and I struck at him. Listen, for a man to eat bear, go to the history, look at the documentary of bear. You will know how powerful. See, one small bear, 165 kg, one small bear. See, if bear slap a man, are you getting me? The head will rotate for 370 degrees. Before the end, before that, we pass it like ball. If you give me a slap, only beer, he will hold you like this. Say, do like this. The head, so you know this head, go roll. 300 degrees. Before the head fall down, only pass like ball. Beer, yes, you fought beer. He said, yes, I fought beer and I caught him by his beer. Yeah. Ah, beer. Okay, no problem. See, that's my credential. That's my tip. If you don't be the case, take this out, take this. Say, no, that I've told you. But because the God shall serve me, he's able. And when he comes from to Goliath said, I pity your mother. Your what? Your mother. Well, no, your mother have lose you. It's not you. You have to jump to that. But I will show you. And then, in credential, it is what that key Goliath. It's your credential that swallowed your problem. Yes, sir. Your credential. Sometimes we don't have this one. We've been looking for money for this one. Trying to gather money for this one. Somebody came one day and said, Prophet, I know this one, I know what our church look like. Give me, I'll be in charge of this. You know what came to my mind? God said to me, take that back very soon if you discover how it went. You don't believe because it's not you. He said, I will be supplying the issue for the chair. Don't spend money. Credential. Can such person cry for contract before contract to get it? No. Credential matters. It's your credential that God used to fight for you. Credential. You look at the choir. You say, choir, I don't want to clothe you. Clothe them. You look at the pastor. And he said, no, pastor, I don't want to get you a suit, a fine suit. You clothe them. You look at the usher. You look at the clothes.